Hey everybody, welcome back. And I'm back. This is Exonerated on the Spinalcraft server. We're just gonna call this season two is what we're gonna do. And it's raining and it's about to be nighttime and I'm all alone. But what I've decided to do is it's time for a new base, it's time for a fresh start. The server has gone to 1.8. And so we have access to all of the cool things, flags, temples, everything. So I was hanging out with a buddy of mine and some friends, and we were playing around at their base for a little bit, and I decided to head south a couple of hundred blocks, and I found this really neat Dark Oak Island. I forget what they're called. Root Forest. There we go. So I found this really cool root forest, and I've decided that I want to set my base up on this island. So the entirety of everything that I have for a base will be here. Thought I saw something. But you can see it's just island all the way around. So we've got the weather here. Make sure that's off. Okay. And I apologize for the delay. It's been a long time since I've had an episode out, and I have been unbelievably busy. We just relocated. We moved about 2 hours away from where I used to live, into a nice more, what would the word be? I guess it would be country, into more of a country setting. But it's going to afford me the opportunity to do a lot more recording, so that's what I'm really looking forward to, is kind of getting back on task, branching out into some other series, and kind of doing new things here. So, at any rate, it's a short preview video. I've got some cool ideas that I want to use for this. Let's see. Oh, there we go. I can make crafting tables, I swear. And let's go ahead and get a chest, and we're going to put that down. And Spinalcraft has a plugin that was developed by the owner of the server, and it is Slip. So all you've got to do is slip, and then you're good to go. You can actually come up and right click from one to the other. Now if you'll see the slip here, I'm actually glitching a little bit. There we go. So you can slip back and forth between places. And I know you've noticed that the name on here is Alicronin. Tyrant's my brother, Barnun's my son. Alicronin is my alt. This is a camera account that I set up so that I can do recordings, time lapses, etc. And so I want to make sure I can use that slip to get out to this island and this island only. And it leads all the way back to my original base, which is kind of nice. So I can pull supplies or whatnot if I feel like I need them. Maybe borrow some of my farms. But the idea is to take all of this stuff that I've built here. And there you can see is my other character. See if we can get him to say hello. Yes. There he goes. So the idea is to take the opportunity to go through and try to start over. Completely start over. Brand new iron farms, brand new cow farms. Basically, we want to take everything we've done here and start over with a twist. I'm going to work a lot more on some aesthetics, so you're going to see a lot more, I think, greenery and design, and that's the sort of stuff that I really want to focus on this new island here. So, let me go ahead and do some clearing, I guess, and I'll be back in a bit, and we'll see if we can't see if we can't show some progress. And I'm back. And while I'm thinking about it, let's go ahead and turn off chat. There we go. Get that out of the way. So I've been really busy. This is actually the next day. I've cleared off the entire island of wood. I've even gone through and removed that little island that was over there. I lit up that island as well. I've not done any caving, but if you notice, I got a little spot right there. In fact, let's go check him out. So my goal is to go through and get, you know, set up basically all of my farms that I had before in kind of a new world with a little new setup. And I stumble across who else, but let's get up on a block. A villager zombie, and he can hold something, so he's savable. So that's what I did, basically, is I just went through and boxed him in. The ground level was actually on par with this level right here. So I took it down a couple of levels. I terraformed it, put some grass out, and some animals have started spawning. And what I've decided to do is kind of take things in a... Well, I'll tell you what I want. So basically, what I've done, and this is just farming for farming's sake. I don't have a plan for all this reed yet. But what I've decided to do, aside from set up ladders to climb. Can we go up? There we go. So what I've decided to do is take this build in a different direction. And I had an idea at first, and I've decided to do something different. This is going to be a tree, but not your normal tree, not your normal Deku tree style tree that's massive and has a huge canopy and everything else. I want this to be a felled tree. So basically, you know, the tree's probably going to come up maybe 45, 50 blocks or so. It's going to be jagged. And then the trunk of the tree is going to lay across here. And what we're going to do is we're going to scatter our farms all throughout the tree, I think, at different spots. And the whole tree is, it's going to have an ancient feel of sorts, but it's going to be like repurposed almost. Like, say, if Ewoks or elves or somebody were living in it, this is what they would do to it. You know, it's no good upright. Let's go ahead and make it livable. So I'm thinking maybe we have the... And speaking of which, how's my weather? Okay, it's off. So basically what I'd like to do, like I said, is have this go up like 40, 50 blocks, kind of tear off jaggedly, and then have the rest of the tree fell laying out across here. And it'll be in multiple pieces, and of course we'll have to work on the roots and whatnot. And this is what I've been doing so far. I used a Deku tree, which, if you didn't know, is a tree in the Zelda series, or, well, at least in one of the show games. And it's hard to see with the rain. It's always raining on the server. Anyway, so basically what I wanted to do is have like a sort of opening that kind of led up a little bit into kind of like the bowels of the tree. And then up here would be kind of like the main area. So there'd be some storage, some rerouting of things, you know, maybe from iron farms or gold farms over that way. Of course, there'd be animal farms that we would have. And they would all kind of route into this. So this area needs to be like the base of the tree. And so what I've started doing is kind of building out the edge of that tree a little bit. And again, I know it's hard to see with the rain, but I can't ever win for losing when it comes to rain on this server. So to be honest with you, I don't even try. But we would go through and have, you know, maybe some roots or whatnot come out of the tree. Let's see. Like this. We don't need wood under there. So we'll just do it like that. And maybe the root turns a little bit and goes out this way. And then a little bit more that way. So that basically, you know, we can kind of add some dimension to the build. And then we'll get it all lit up creatively. You know, it's going to be overgrown with moss. Of course, little bits like this aren't going to show because we don't want to expose the edge of the ground. We want the tree to look like it's all the way into the ground, not just kind of sitting on it. And needless to say, I got a tremendous amount of wood from this area, and it's not going to be enough if I could just... Oops. There's some dark wood. There's some more dark wood. There's some more dark wood. And I got some sand. This is all the grass that I dug up from here. And there's some miscellaneous materials. But hopefully, with this much dark oak, we'll be able to get a really good kind of grip on how the tree is going to look. So this is... This entrance here will kind of look like a mouth of sorts, but there will be no eyes or nothing. It'll just kind of be the tree laying back. I want some like moss growing on it, so we'll bring some ivy into it, and we'll have to go visit our string farm at the other base because we want to be able to control where the ivy is growing. And then I also want to figure out a way to work in an iron farm and a gold farm. Those two have to happen. I just simply go through too much iron not to have one. I did not light this other side up. That was on purpose. I wanted to be able to farm zombies in the meantime, so if I ran across another villager zombie that would hold on to items, I could just buy them. And then at least I would have villagers on the island to breed, and I wouldn't have to go hunt them down. There's a spider jockey. And another skeleton. I wonder if we've got any more zombies anywhere over here. It would be awesome to catch the other one on camera. The one thing I am thankful for is this island had no creatures except for a handful of sheep on it. And the one thing I'm thankful for is that they've started spawning since I leveled the trees. So, you know, the creature, I forget what it's called, non-hostile mob spawning is working okay, which is good, because that'll save me a lot of trouble. I've got a couple of sheep down here. There's one... cow there, and there was another one over here playing in the water at some point. He may be over this way. But regardless, yep, there he is. Hiding on the edge. But that way, you know, we could just repopulate our own, get them set up into farms, and build without having to worry about food or anything. Good friends of mine, Gold Dragon and the one and only Katie are both that way, and so I'll probably link up with them at some point with a tunnel or something. I'm thinking like a tree trunk sort of artery that runs along the base of the ocean here. You know, maybe you hop into a track up here and it takes you down underneath. And you go underneath, riding along the ocean floor with some brown glass or something. I think that could be really cool. And help feed into the theme of the kind of the dead tree, reaching out for whatever it can grab onto to stay alive, even though it failed because it'll be laying down, busted. I did not think to save any leaves when I got started building. Or tearing down trees, rather. So that's going to be fun. I'll have to go through and hunt down a bunch of leaves. And there's a villager zombie. Could we have found our zombie already? Wouldn't that be amazing? Let's find out. Come here, buddy. You want some of that? I know you do. You want some of that? Come on. Let me get you... Get on the land. Get on the land. I wonder... Ooh. Aren't you a tough guy? I wonder if I gave you a piece of armor, would you take it? Why don't you follow me? I'll make you a piece of armor. Come on. Watch my back here. I'm liable to get jumped at any moment. Let's do this. There's a step for you. There's a step for you. Look at this. We are selfless. Selfless. We make you steps. Places for you to walk. Why don't you come along, guy? Come hang out with us. I got your brother over here. Oh, there's another one. Could we have gotten any luck here? Now, one of you nitwits is bound to be able... And there's a regular zombie. Let's get rid of him. Yep, got rid of him. Let's grab this meat. No, don't hit me. Don't beat me up. Don't do it. Don't do it. Come on. One of you guys want that? What about this? Do you want this instead? Oh, you guys are going to be the sort of jerks who don't want anything, aren't you? Come on. Take your zombie flesh. I'm trying to get them a little bit closer over here. Get them to this side. At least so as I can make... God, I wish I had the stuff for potions. I would just box them up now. But I do not have that stuff on me. I don't think these guys are going to work. No, do not get Sunny on me. Let's do this. Let's see if I got a diamond pickaxe. Let's do that. I'll waste 3 diamonds. Pick it up. Come on. No! And the rain's going away. I can see you will die because the rain is gone. And you won't pick up my pickaxe so I can save you. I don't want to use my diamond sword. That one... I'm running out of options. Yes, I know. I know. I know. I know. Don't yell at me. You guys are jerks. That's okay. You're not gonna work anyway. Go ahead. Die. Alright, well, and then... Ooh, one of them dropped something. He dropped an iron sword. I think they both did. So at any rate, ooh, I got another pig spawned. So now I got 2 pigs, too. So at any rate, that's my plans for the island. I don't have a lot of time to record today, but... I did, only because I spent so much time clearing this thing yesterday that I was able to make some progress. So, I think what I'd like to do to work on next time, let's just toss all that. I think what I'd like to work on for next time is getting these guys potionable. I wonder, let's check. Let's see what we got going on for potions. Potions. Well, I got some water bottles. Oh, weakness right there. There we go. And I got 2 golden apples. So I'll at least be able... Let me not put those on my hot bar, lest I do a pause on pause and feed them to something else. Alright. Okay, so this should help, actually. This should help a lot. Let's build this guy's little fortification up a little bit. I don't want any access through the corners, if you know what I mean. Like, no being able to glitch in on a corner and tap the guy. So let's do that. That's pretty much all the way around. And then... can't get out that way. So that helps me out. Alright, we're gonna splash potion of weakness, even though I got a little bit on me. And we're gonna... There we go. So at least when we do come back, we'll be able to start off with... I don't have to worry about babies getting in there either. So when we do come back, I'll be able to have bait of sorts. He'll be able to sit here and lure them from all over the place, which will be nice. Maybe I can just get another regular zombie. In fact, let's do that. Let's just make a little cubby hole now. Get out of the way, pig. Let's do it. Alright, cool. So that'll be our little... And I'll make... let's put some torches down. And we want some torches on the inside. Excessive lighting is always a plus for villagers. And here we go. Wait, do I have any slabs? I do not, but I have some oak. And I prefer to use that instead of wasting my dark oak. At least the logs I can farm back up. Okay. Let's see. Let's do this. This way I don't have to worry about any other mobs popping up in there. They won't jump that gap. So no harm, no foul. And we'll do this number. And then this way we'll be able to seal in another zombie. I'll honestly probably punch him, pull him in, and then, you know, push him, or start him, and then push him in the rest of the way. So, at any rate, been pretty busy. Just wanted to show you guys what's going on, give you an update, and hopefully next time when we come back, we'll be able to start off working on the base of the tree that fell. I don't want it to be this whole island. Let me kind of get back up there and kind of show what's going on with that. I don't want it to be the whole island. I want it to be maybe half to two-thirds as thick. So we'll have to... Ooh, almost jump off the edge. The tree itself will probably loop around right about where the villager is and come back around, and that'll be the base of the tree, and then we'll have, of course, roots leading down on every side. And I think, excuse me, I think it would be cool to have different sections of the tree fall off. So maybe we have one long tree that follows all over here, and maybe there's another piece kind of falling back on the backside over that island. Yeah, I think that would be really cool. So when we come back next time, that's definitely the start, is kind of landscaping this island out to be the size that we want it to be for the base of the tree, and doing some of the roots and whatnot. And then we'll have to start laying out the log. And it's going to be a log, because as wide as this tree is around, that's how tall this log has to be going out. So I think we'll be pretty set for space. We'll be able to get, you know, a nice, let's see here, we got 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So you're looking at a trio of with a circumference of like 50, 60, I'm sorry, with a radius of like, or a diameter rather, of like 50, 60 blocks. That's a pretty tall building. So, you know, we'll have a nice long, tall log broken off into pieces. And maybe we will have some leaves kind of down falling into the water, like wilted branches or something. But at any rate, until next time, this is Exonerated. I'm really excited to start the new season and kind of get underway. And yeah, I've got my motivation back, ready to do it now that the server is 1.8, and see what we can't pull off. So until next time, I will catch you guys later. Have a good one.